everybody. Tim Lito with Mark
Shire. How you doing?
Connolly Memorial Stadium as the Acton Boxborough Colonials get set to take on the Woburn Tanners. And Mark, it's the home, it's the actual season opener. What am I talking about?
Yeah, that's right.
Here?
No more preseason.
Oh,
no more scrimmages.
It's been a long season. They have Noah's Ark out there. It's been, you know, there's water, there's floods, there's hurricanes. But we're here for the opener.
Thank goodness. Took about 2 hours to get here, too.
But I'll tell you, I'm real excited about this for a lot of reasons. First of all, it's a new season. We got a brand new defense to show out in the field. And especially, Mark, a lot of these kids on this team and this year are kids that I coached for a long time.
I know that. Your first Pop Warner group.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
The graduates are out there, and I'm very proud as a father, and I'm really excited about this year's AV football team.
Well, it's going to be a great season. You know, last year, about a year ago today, we beat Woburn 23-0. And we just rolled all over them. Rob Gogan ran for 2 touchdowns. It was Ethan Duke's first start as a junior, and he was just asked to manage the game. Now, Woburn didn't get a first down until 2.5 minutes to go in the game. We totally dominated. Ethan was only asked to throw 4 times. He completed 2 passes for 16 yards, and all that's gonna change tonight. It's gonna be a tougher game tonight because we've graduated 21 seniors, most of them starters. We're only returning a few starters. Woburn is returning 8 starters on offense and 7 starters on defense, and they have one of the best backs in New England in Chucky Ortiz. And I saw a YouTube video of one of his punt returns. I want to tell you, this guy broke 4 tackles and then had one guy to beat in the end zone and did a move on him that was an ankle breaker. So he's the guy to stop, Chucky Ortiz. And Ethan Dukes has really matured. He's had 1 season of experience at quarterback. And Ethan is the nicest kid you'd ever want to meet. But I want to tell you, when you talk to him, and you know, he'd help old, you know, old ladies across the street. But when he gets on that football field, there's nothing more he likes to do than hit. He's also playing linebacker. And if you ask Ethan, would he rather throw a touchdown pass or make a good stick? I think he'd rather make a good stick.
Absolutely. These kids are tough. We got a lot of speed, too. We got a few backs that I think you're going to hear by the end of the season. And, you know, I'm real excited. We're going to get close to the national anthem here. So let's cut over to the national anthem, let these kids get started, and we'll be back in just a couple of minutes.
All right, and let's play some football. Okay.
All right, Mark, here we go. It's a beautiful night, I'll tell you, as I said in the opener. It's been raining, I think, for a week and a half.
Yeah, it's absolutely picture-perfect night. I mean, they were evacuating people in Worcester today, so we're really lucky to have a gorgeous night like tonight. And AB is going to be kicking off.
And back deep is the dangerous number 2, Chucky Ortiz, as well as number 19, Nico Cornelio.
Nico Cornelio, captain. Okay. Jack Perry kicking off.
And it's a bloop kick. And it's mishandled and the ball's loose. But recovered back by Woburn, number 5, Jared O'Brien. So Woburn will get it 1st and 10 on their own 30-yard line.
Well, hopefully we'll see a lot of kickoffs, Tim, and I think you'll see every one exactly like that. I think we have perfected that kickoff, that 34, 35-yard kickoff. To about the 25-yard line.
It almost worked that time as Woburn sets up with Hunter Romano, the quarterback, and the give is to Ortiz through the off-tackle slot. He gets out in the open, and he's got some green as he goes all the way down and pushed out of the bounds at the 30-yard line. Woburn, Chucky Ortiz with an explosive start.
Well, that's exactly what we were talking about in the opening. When I spoke with Coach Gallant, he said, we've got to just stop Ortiz. He's the guy. It's almost like Kobe Bryant. You give Kobe Bryant his 30 points, you try to stop everyone else, but he's going to get his yardage tonight.
Make that the 34-yard line, and this time it's a buck up the middle and stopped by AB for maybe just a yard gain.
And that was their big fullback, Anthony Mendonca.
Now, Woburn always has a big fullback. I mean, that's
Woburn always has a big team.
Yeah.
I looked at their roster. They're about five or six guys over 280 pounds.
You know why?
Thankfully, a few of them are sophomores, but I was looking at 305, 320.
I know the reason why they're big. I'll tell you in the next play here. Okay, wing left. This time the give is to Ortiz as he's trapped in the backfield. And pushed
okay.
back by Mikey Duggan.
All right.
Let's see who else here. We got Matt Marcotte first to the scene, and Mikey Duggan, and let's see, number 53, Sean Whittier as well.
Well, that's the kind of gang tackling and pursuit that this team is going to have to do all season long, because there are no real superstars on this team this year. It's going to be a total team effort, and it was on that play.
Bring up now third and about 17, let's see, 21. Got to get my math right.
Okay.
19.
Going to look at number three, Billy Cuozzo.
All right, back.
Oh, they got him. They got him.
All right. Mikey Duggan in his first sack of the season.
Great pursuit by AB, and that puts him in down in punting territory right now with 9:16 to go, and AB's going to get the ball. Well, give Chucky one moment in the sun and let the sun set on him.
Absolutely. All right. Back deep for AB is Billy Jackman. And it's a good punt.
That's going to go. That's going to go.
In.
That's a touchback.
Just a little. A little too far, so that'll be brought out to the 20 as AB gets started on offense. And boy, a lot of weapons on this team. Now, to say no superstars, but you know, it's you never know who the superstars are going to be.
Well, that's what
well,
I love
that's
about
right.
the first game of the season.
That's exactly yeah. right. You just don't know who's going to emerge. One potential superstar, of course, is number 44, Kyle Sweendog Sweeney, who runs a legitimate 4.5 40. That is fast in any football league.
Kyle Sweendog Sweeney has gave me so many touchdowns and Pop Warner made me look a lot better than
you're,
I could be.
You're a lot better coach than you actually were.
There he is. Cuts through and gives a loop of his own version of Chucky Ortiz. And that kid's gonna be done. Let's see.
He's running away.
Touchdown. Sweet dog.
And did you see him run away from Ortiz?
Absolutely.
He ran away from Chucky Ortiz. That was a 100-yard dash, and Ortiz at about 80 yards said, I give up. I can't catch this kid.
Not many kids that, you know, when you see him on the 20-yard line running away from a team, when you say, that kid is gone. You know, when you're calling a game, but it definitely, he was going away like Seabiscuit, I'll tell you.
Well, you know, it's so funny. You've heard so much about Ortiz's speed. And just to get into a foot race with Sweeney, I was really wondering who's the faster back. And it's very clear that Sweeney has really got exceptional speed.
And lateral quickness. I mean, the kid really does. He's got explosive steps. Of course, you know, you switch gears to Billy Jackman, you get a whole other can of worms.
And then you got James Sumner, who's a third back in that mold. Okay, Jack Perry.
All right, the kick is up, and it is good.
It looks perfect to me, of
That's
course.
That's a good start.
Of course, from this angle, I can't figure out any. I don't call them until they raise their hands over their head. That's a great start. Boy, I tell you, what a statement to make on the first play from scrimmage.
The only bad thing about that drive is we didn't use enough time. Clock, you know, but I'll tell you, that's exciting.
Well, you know, the strength through the years, even though we've had really good offensive teams, the strength of this team has always been its defense. And Bill, Coach Maver really preaches that the, you know, the old adage, offense sells tickets and defense wins games. And last year, AB was the stingiest defense in all of Eastern Massachusetts. Over 100 teams, they gave up just about a touchdown a game. And they're gonna try to have to continue that. But with guys like Sweeney and Jackman, who knows?
We got a new special teams coach this year. The you know, the famous Henry Morris, who's thrown many touchdowns and just gave us so many dramatic moments.
He sure did, and he gave us dramatic moments in three different sports.
Absolutely.
He was a great baseball catcher, a point guard in basketball, and a fabulous quarterback.
All right, Jack Perry, this time he kicks it away, and it goes to number 19.
Okay, great coverage.
Nico Cornelio.
Yeah, Nico Cornelio. He'll stay in the backfield along with Mendoca and Ortiz. And Hunter Romano is starting his first year. He's a senior, and this is his first year playing quarterback. He's looked good in scrimmages. He really favors his right-hand side, does a lot of bootlegs, a lot of play action. He can throw the ball. They're not a one-dimensional team by any means.
It's another new thing about AB. Look at that, a 4-3 defense. I mean, you just don't see a 4-3 very often. There goes Ortiz again.
Oh, a good tackle. That is a saving tackle. If you can talk about making a game touchdown saving tackle about 6 yards through.
Runs a lot like George Cran. You know, that kind of
George Cran.
He has that side-to-side, kind of gait to him as he...
Well, Billy Jackman made a touchdown saving tackle on that play.
This time, a dive up the middle and stop. So AB covering the middle of the field as they give Ortiz a breather.
And of course, Duggan is jumping on the pile. You know, he's trying to just get his stats up. You know, he'll wind up with 16 tackles tonight. About 8 of them will be jumping on the pile.
He's a blitz dog, though.
He really is. There's going to be a lot of blitzing this year, too. Coach Gallant said, just watch for the blitz.
Ortiz, and they get the throw off, and it's complete to the tight end, number 86.
Yeah, that was to Big John Kincannon, who is another co-captain.
That was a dangerous pass, Mark. I don't even know if he saw what he threw there.
He just threw that up for grabs, and that's a lucky break for the Tanners because they really had Romano stopped. Reminded me a little bit of that Patriots-Giants play there where they just couldn't get him.
High formation for the Tanners. And wow, Ortiz explodes, hesitates, cuts back, and continues up close to midfield for a first down and more.
Yeah, he's a game breaker. That looked a little bit like that YouTube video, the way he can cut. He's got great lateral motion.
He's off the field for a breather. Woburn taking a long time between plays here.
All right, watch for some play action now because they go to play action a lot, and with Ortiz out, they may do that. Nope.
That's a fullback up the middle. Good room as tackle made by Ethan Dukes.
Okay, Mendonca is a tough runner, big kid, a good blocker, good runner.
As Coach Maver calls a timeout, this 4-3 defense, Mark, it's really a very, it's a brand new defense for AB. I don't think AB only situationally has ever played a 4-3. And so it's going to take some time to sync up.
Well, I think part of the reason that they're playing a 4-3 defense instead of the 5-2 with the two pluggers is that, number one, we've got a very strong line. And also, we have a completely brand new secondary. We graduated our entire secondary. So we've got a lot of untested kids that are in the secondary.
Yeah, and I also think that, we're just seeing more and more passing attacks across the DCL and elsewhere. And a 4-3 just gives you a little bit better flexibility because effectively that nose guard is now a more of a flex player, an extra linebacker. A nickel back, depending on
exactly.
Can
go back in coverage. Defense. Exactly. Okay, we've got first and 10 from the 39.
That matters less against Woburn. So in some ways, we're test. This is test for our future. All right,
good.
Ortiz, stop.
All right.
Backfield, and it's Mikey Duggan with the tackle, and along with number 20, Mike Murphy.
Okay, that was not a cheap tackle by Duggan. I've got to apologize to Duggan here.
I know how that kid can play. When I used to run my scout O or my O against the scout D, and Mikey would be playing middle linebacker against me, no matter what I called, he'd be on the ball.
That was great middle. That was Dick Butkus land there. Here's your play
action. All right,
there's
a rollout. And it's going to be a keeper. It's good. Oh, what a hit.
Oh, my goodness.
And it's Mikey Duggan again with that hit. Hello. That was vicious.
Romano looked like he was really getting a head of steam up and was going to get some good yardage on that. And then he went into an immovable object by the name of Mike Duggan.
Third and five, a long five. See what Woburn calls here in this situation. You know, the way Ortiz has been running.
Well, yeah, you can give it to Ortiz twice, and most likely you're going to get something.
All right, wing left. And it's a fake to Ortiz, and it's a screen pass, a great call as they get out near the first down marker.
Okay, that was a beautiful play call. And that's right at the first down mark. I don't know if they'll measure for that. Oh, we got a holding call.
Yeah.
All right.
Wow.
That's going to bring third and long. Whole different ball game now. Okay, push him back. Oh, personal foul, roughing the passer. Didn't he give the holding call?
I thought so.
It looked like he gave the holding call. I thought it was coming back the other way, but it's going to be a roughing the passer call, which is going to bring it deep into AB territory. Yeah, roughing the passer.
First down. That's a very complicated call by the refs. I was lost.
Let's see where they put the ball here. It's going to be at the 19-yard line, I think. He's walking it off.
A precise calculation.
Okay, first and 10 from the 19. 4:42 to go in the first quarter. AB 7, Panthers nothing.
I formation to give us to Ortiz off tackles. He cuts up the lane for about 2 or 3 yards. Good defense that time.
It was good defense, but it was also a great move by Ortiz because he could have easily been stopped at the line of scrimmage, and he just kind of slid his way through for about 2 yards. This defensive line is very impressive.
I see Captain Peter Trombley out there playing linebacker. Great kid.
Oh, yeah.
Right, Delaware sweep, and this time
Ortiz
is taken down by Mikey Duggan
right.
And company. Mikey Duggan's got 4 tackles already.
I actually counted 5. I counted the jump on as 1. Great, great play. And he just hung on to his uniform long enough to get help here, and it's 3rd and 14, 3rd and 15.
The rest of this this line, you got Matt Marcotte, who can lift Volkswagens with a single hand.
And then you can have Brooks Pullen, who can lift Matt Marcotte lifting the Volkswagen.
That's impressive. All right, play option.
Oh, yeah!
Sack.
All right!
Mikey Duggan!
Oh, Mikey Duggan is... Talk about making a name for yourself. This is the Luke Kuechly from Boston College. He's trying to do a Luke Kuechly impression here.
All right. So that'll bring up 4th down and just a long way.
Well, we talked at the opening about players who are going to present themselves as real stars this year, and that always happens between that junior and senior year. And Mike Duggan is number 1 here.
Wow, look at this.
Okay.
Swinging gate.
A little quick kick maybe. a little pooch? No, it's Ortiz. And then nothing done.
Oh, what a play by Brooks Pullen.
Wow. And Brooks Pullen not only showed his strength, but his speed, and Ortiz is hurt. He's shaking up on the play.
That's, you know, getting tackled by Brooks.
He is getting up slowly. All you need is one hit from Brooks Pullen, and you know you've been in a football game.
Wow, interesting formation.
I thought he was going to throw the ball. I mean, that's a lot of yardage to make up trying to rush the ball on fourth down.
He's so dangerous in the open field, though, Mark. You know, I can see the strategy, that's for sure.
All right, well, we have held serve here with 2:16 to go. We've got a touchdown on the Tanners, and we take possession at the 29-yard line. We have only won one play so far in the first quarter, one offensive play. It was a good one.
It was a good one. Look at the AB band on the other side of the field, spread out. This time, look at this. They try a run and nothing going there on the right side.
Okay, that was good yardage. J.D. Powell, a junior from the Tanners, stopped Sweeney. But he still got good yardage on that. It's about second and a long five.
Couldn't even pick up that. JP breaks out in the huddle, lines up in a strong right.
Oh, maybe a little illegal procedure there. Yep, five. We just lost the 5 yards we gained, so it'll go back to second and 10.
1:35 to go in the first quarter. It's been a fast quarter, but one play or three plays run by us right now on offense.
Now they'll also try to get the ball to Sweeney using a bubble screen. A bubble screen is where Sweeney splits out and they throw it to him. All he needs is one block from the tight end, and then he can be gone.
Play action. And it's Jackman. Oh! Just stretched out off of his fingertips. And he had a couple steps.
Oh, Billy was behind him and just off the fingertips. A nice touch pass by Ethan Dukes. And that's the way to stretch out the field. That's the way to loosen up the defense. You're also going to see backup quarterback Peter Cannell at receiver this year. They're going to use his height and athleticism.
All right. Slot right. And it's a quarterback keeper as Ethan Dukes gets 3 or 4 yards up the middle. That'll bring up fourth down.
Okay, Ethan Dukes is the punter. And when I spoke with Ray about Ethan punting, he said that they've got some plays around midfield for Ethan because he can do a lot with the football. He can run, he can pass. Having your quarterback as your punter brings up a lot of possibilities. And he's going to kick it away here. I don't see any fakes here for sure.
And back deep is the very dangerous Chucky Ortiz.
And no, that's not the quarter. It's a timeout.
It's like timeout
AB. AB timeout. Okay, they call the 22nd timeout, probably to get their alignment correct in the punting game. Yeah, look for Dukes to really employ the quarterback sneak a lot. He looked very good in a couple of scrimmages. He was getting 10, 11 yards on quarterback sneaks, going behind Pete Trombley.
Strong kid. Good kick. Off and perfect.
That is not returnable on the 26th.
Just what you want with Chucky Ortiz back there. So it'll be first and 10 Tanners on their own 27-yard line.
I hate to say this, but every time I hear Chucky,
I think of that those horror movies, you know, like Bride of Chucky or you know, Chucky Comes Home or whatever.
They spent a lot of advertising money in that campaign.
The only two Chuckies I know are the Horror Show and Chuck E. Cheese, and I don't know which one is worse.
I never think of Chuck E. Cheese. I always think of the Horror Show. I know what you mean.
Oh, we did a birthday party at Chuck E. Cheese once, and that was the one and last time we'd ever do that.
All right, here we go. I formation to give us to Ortiz.
Oh, he doesn't have a chance. They're in. Whoa.
Another tackle by Mikey Duggan.
I'll have what he's having. Mikey Duggan is just playing his own football game here. It's almost like Woburn doesn't exist. He's really embracing that middle linebacker position. And frankly, you know, we've never really had a middle linebacker because of the 5-2 alignment.
Yeah, right.
So this is a brand new position. All right, that's the end of the first quarter. Good quarter for AB. Even though they've only run four plays, it's hit 7-0.
Now it's been, we're starting to see the tip of the iceberg of what AB can become. You see the offense has some explosiveness to it. We haven't even seen really the likes of Billy Jackson yet, or really Matt Marcotte out of the fullback spot, or Brooks Poulin yet.
Right, or Matt Brogy.
We've had a lot of action here, and of course, the keepers here with Ethan Dukes, and this is just a lot of capability on that offense.
Yeah, there are a lot of weapons, but the biggest weapon is the defense, and right now, the defense has shown up. And the linebacker play has been so good that the secondary really hasn't had to be much involved in the action.
Ortiz.
Nothing.
Stop.
Nothing doing.
About a yard gain by Jake Plecky and company. I think Peter Trobley was in on that.
Jake Plecky is one kid I think is going to have a big year this year. He's got big shoes to fill with Wes Schroll graduating, but Jake had an excellent junior year, and I think he's going to improve on that this year.
And Sean Whittier is out there getting a lot of playing time, 5'5".
Yeah, 5'5", that's right.
That kid played for me as well. That kid's got a heart bigger than his entire stadium. Let me tell you something about that kid. Terrific ball player. Wow, they picked the wrong receiver.
That was interference.
Number 3, Billy Cuso.
Yeah, that was clearly interference. It's going to be first down, Woburn.
That's a good play in high school. You know, they don't call it to the spot of the ball, so you really have an advantage if you see a play that could be a breakaway.
Yeah, the Cuso name in Woburn is like the Flutie name in Natick, the Hebert name name in Acton. It's a very, very prominent athletic family. First down on the 40-yard line for Woburn. And Kincannon, number 86, is checking in. 6'1", 210 receiver.
Okay, first and 10 on the 40-yard line. And give us Ortiz again as he sidesteps.
Oh, there's a flag. It looks like a hold. That's it. That's in the area of holding. So let's see what they call. Yep. Going to push him back 10 yards.
Ortiz is very effective in traffic. He's right in the middle of the hole. You see the quick sidestep, you know, side-to-side agility.
He's got those nightclub moves, you know? I mean, I could picture him, you know, in a nightclub. He'd be great.
He is. Got that.
Okay, they're going to mark off 10 yards at some point. Here we go. First and 20 for the Tanners. 10:01 to go in the second quarter.
Fake to Ortiz. And it's a fumble.
Oh, I think he got it. I think Romano recovered it.
Boy.
Boy, that is a swarming defense. And once
really
again,
aggressive.
Duggan.
I don't know who had their hand, got their hand on that football.
Marquardt was in there, Duggan. They had three of four Colonials on top of Romano. And Romano is coming out.
Evan Lonergan checks in.
Evan Lonergan. And Ortiz is in the Wildcat.
Oh! And he's down by Mikey Duggan.
Mikey Duggan, and they recovered.
Wow.
Mikey Duggan forced a fumble, recovers. Oh, he is
by,
having.
I think the recover is Matt Marquardt, maybe?
Matt, I think Marquardt got on it. Duggan made the initial hit. And Mikey Duggan, I don't know, your next door neighbor's having the game of the century right now. What's gotten into him?
It doesn't surprise me, really.
Really, talking about coming to play. Great field position. In the red zone on the 17-yard line.
All right, Ethan Dukes back to pass. Under traffic there, and he's gonna get sacked at the all the way back for a huge loss. They are all the way back to the 35-yard line.
Yeah, Ethan wants to have that play back.
That looked like I would guess a screen pass.
Yeah, that was a screen pass. Yeah, he didn't have his receiver open and just should have just gotten rid of the ball, but hung on to it, and now we're in a
second and
a ton.
About 35 yards or so. 30 yards.
Well, let's see what we can make up. Jack Perry almost made a 45-yarder in a scrimmage.
All right, Kyle Sweeney cuts back against the grain.
Oh!
Oh, oh my God! Ortiz is out of his shoes after that move. My God, that cutback. Did you see that?
Talk about an ankle-breaking move. Oh. I mean, Sweeney broke Ortiz's ankle on that, and I think he made a mistake right at the end. He had the pylon. He had Ortiz beat, but he stopped. But he had Ortiz beat. It's first and goal now.
What a play.
I'm talking about 40-yard field goals, and I keep forgetting that Kyle Sweeney is in the backfield.
That was, and I've seen him make that move in Pop Warner, I'm telling you. That doesn't surprise me either. He's had that since he was a little kid, since he was 8 years old.
I don't have my computer with me, but I think his rushing average right now is about 46.3. Unbelievable.
And of course,
what a move on Ortiz.
And he's running behind that great offensive line that we haven't talked much about yet. But again, you have Peter Trombley at center. You got, you know, Matt Marquardt at fullback. You have or Brooks Brulin, take your pick on that thing there. And you have of course Mikey Duggan. You got
You got Brandon Sides, and you got number 73. Yeah,
line. Another,
and you got Sean McGavick, who is
McGavick,
a force.
He is
a force, and he's going to be here for the next 2 years because he's only a junior, and Sean is opening some big holes.
235 pounds, Sean McGavick. Wow, look at this. This is long left. Run behind strength.
No problem. No problem. Did you see what McGavick did to their defensive tackle? He just pancaked him.
And there's Sean McGavick's mom and dad down there.
Well done. Well done. Nice block. A whole bunch of nice blocks. Got a timeout here. Jack Perry in for the extra point. And Woburn calls timeout. 13 to nothing AB, 7:54 to go. Well, this is a lot better than the pronosticators pronosticated.
You know,
all the experts were picking Woburn here.
We still got a lot of football left, Mark.
That's
but
right.
I'll tell you, what we see here so far, though, is that we may not have the traditional, you know, big running back that we've had from time to time, but between, you know, we have Kyle Swindog Sweeney, who's lightning in a bottle.
Yeah, and Billy Jackman, we haven't seen Billy Jackman yet, but he can do the same thing. I think that's offside. That looked like offside
sure
Woburn.
Did.
I don't see
sure
any flags.
Any flags.
That was, they missed it. They missed that end coming offside. 13 to nothing. Hopefully that won't be relevant.
7:54 to go in the first half and a beautiful night. Just the perfect temperature for a football game.
Well, you know, you're talking about AB coaches. You've got Henry Morris and then you got Mikey Morris. We wanted Mikey to be our sideline reporter. And now he's up in the booth.
We threw a lot of cash at Mikey
Morris.
I did.
We made him offer. He couldn't refuse it. He refused it.
Unbelievable. That Coach Maver won again.
And also, Mark Smith is celebrating his 40th anniversary in coaching this year. And is a fantastic guy, a fantastic coach, and he's a big part of the success of this program.
That's, you know, he's often, you know, out scouting other teams on a Friday night, so he really doesn't get the enjoyment of watching the team. So scouting our next opponent, he's done that for years and years and years. And so appreciated when you go to the football banquets every year. Mark Smith is just, you know, somebody that they always talk about.
Yeah, absolutely. And he is watching Chelmsford tonight because that's our next opponent next Friday night at home, the Chelmsford Lions. They're going to be a strong team again.
A squib down the middle of the field and mishandled there, but covered up. A lot of razzle-dazzle on the special teams there. Henry Morris showing that, you know, a quarterback knows how to do this stuff.
Absolutely, he's a great special teams coach. All right, Romano back in. They're not in the Wildcat. They're gonna be in their traditional offense and they may have to open it up a little bit. They have not run the bootleg yet. Fan scouting, they bootleg a lot. Let's see.
AB showing blitz up the middle and it worked. As let's see, it's Mikey Duggan with
I'm
the tackle.
I'm sorry, who made that tackle? I didn't catch that. 58?
Let's get a tape recorder.
I feel like it's Groundhog Day here, you know? Duggan. Well, you know, we mentioned Mikey Duggan's name and his number, but everyone else makes that possible too.
Well,
it's not a one-man show.
Line, that defensive line, that front four, nasty front four.
Look at the blitz here.
Ortiz.
Oh yes.
Tripped up by Mikey Duggan.
And Ortiz he's just getting beat up tonight, and he is hobbling right now. I don't think he's at 100%. That means he'll probably run for a, you know, 63-yard touchdown on the next play, but he has just gotten beaten up by the AB defense.
50-50. Imagine that right side, Matt Marcotte and Brooks pulling there. That's strong. All right, reverse, and no mas, as looks like.
Yeah, Brooks that's pulling right there.
Right there waiting for him.
They
good
really
coaching. We know what they're going to do there.
They really look like they're in the Woburn huddle. I mean, it's that impressive.
Should sure the Chelmsford scouts are here taking a look at this.
Too much time? Okay, they're going to move Woburn back. Another 5 yards.
And be fourth with the ball on the 22-yard line. Back deep is Billy Jackman.
They're coming.
He's getting it off. Oh, and he just gets it off.
No flag. No flag. The Woburn punter, really tried to sell it. I want to give that guy an Academy Award nomination because he held on to his ankle like, oh, my ankle's killing me. But the ref didn't buy it.
All right, first and 10 Colonials near midfield here, and about their own 40, let's see where they spot this, 48-yard line.
They're still deciding where to spot it. You got it, 48-yard line. Got Matt Brogy right in back of Dukes.
Absolutely, another great ball player.
Ooh, oh yeah, there was a little movement. Jake just flinched just a little bit there.
Just a little movement. The ref looking right at it.
Yeah, it's really hard to hide when the ref is like 5 feet from you looking right at you.
All right, first and 15. All right, Kyle Sweeney on a Delaware sweep. He cuts through. He's got room. He's got 9 yards. Actually,
he's got 14.
Nine, 14.
14
nine
yards.
Plus five. Here we go. Wow.
You know, Tim, we talk about Kyle Sweeney as simply a speedster, but you know, he's 5'9". He's a solid 165, and you can see his strength because first tackler can't bring him down.
Oh, and he's a very tough kid. I'm just telling you, just from a young age, the kid is took a lot of punishment in Pop Warner. Always, you know, wanted to go back in, never back down from anything. Really, really tough kid. And very,
okay, measurement very here, and it looks like we're about an inch.
I would say we're short. Let's see.
An inch or two. Looks like about a sheet of paper. Second in a sheet of paper.
All right,
this really gives Ethan a lot of options here. Perfect time for play action or a little. They have not run the counter yet. That may be because the counter was not terribly successful last year. They had a lot of trouble running that play last year.
I'm not sure they want to show that to Chelmsford tonight. I mean, the counter, you run that wing back counter with Jackman, that should be a good play. Swing dog in the wing back spot.
Oh, there, Pilecki. Jake. Yeah, Jake's just a little over anxious right now. And he is in that spot where he is totally exposed right at the end.
Second and five and a sheet of paper.
Good measurement.
All right, wing left. And sneak up the middle.
And I wouldn't be surprised, Tim, if one time this year Dukes just broke that. Because he's got the strength to do that. And he gets good yardage on that quarterback sneak. And the key to that is Trombley just kicking out and getting his defender out of the way. And that defender's a real big kid, that nose guard. Really big kid. James Sumner.
James Sumner with a big time run.
Oh, yeah.
Across the 20 to the 14-yard line. James Sumner carrying on the Sumner tradition.
James Sumner, the little brother of Jake White Shoes Sumner, number 47 in your playbook. He doesn't have the white shoes, but he certainly runs like his brother.
He sure does. What a great run. Caught Woburn off guard. Kyle Sweendog, and he gets just dragged down. His cutting, his body was at an angle here, and he just was just torn down. Second and 10.
Yeah, I think in that situation, he didn't quite follow the let the Brandon Sides block develop. I think he didn't follow the block. He cut toward the middle. I think if he followed Brandon, he would have gotten more yardage. That was a nice cutout block by Brandon Sides. Brandon's brother, of course, went on to play for WPI and was captain of WPI in his senior year.
All right, flex behind the strong formation.
Oh, look at that!
Kyle Sweendog, Sweeney powering up the middle. Broke about five tackles up the center line.
That's Kyle Sweeney looking like Bronco Nazurski. Nazurski, is that? What was his name?
Yeah,
nobody knows who Bronco Nazurski is.
You go way back.
You have to be 85 years old to know who that is.
All right, third and maybe two and a half. See if we line up at flex again. And we do. Flex, long left. Sweendog again. Cuts
no
out,
problem. No problem.
Keeps
no
going.
Problem.
It's touchdown.
Oh my goodness.
Those feet just keep chugging there. Kyle Sweendog.
And he just pinballed right into. He looked like a pinball in a pinball machine going right into the end zone there, just bouncing off tacklers.
What great balance and that, you know, that whole line. That time, you know, with Peter Trombley up front, Sean McGavick, Brooks Poulin, these kids, they're moving some bodies out
there. They're really
there.
Strong. I mean, they may have the best line that they've had in years.
Brandon really size at the big block.
Oh, man, a little fake. Trickery.
Oh, look at that. A little
little extracurricular activity, too.
The refs just keeps everybody in line, and 2:22 to go, and it's the Colonials 19, and the Tanners nothing.
Well, they wanted to get that two-point conversion. That was Tom Saponaro, wasn't it? Mark Saponaro's younger brother.
Yep.
Mark, number 33, had a great career at AB, was one of those players that made that huge leap from the junior to senior year and became a real star that senior year.
So 2:22 to go in the first half. It's been a nice first half, Mark. You know,
I'm enjoying myself, yeah.
You know, the score's right, the weather's right. Seen a lot of new faces out there in the blue and gold, establishing their reputation for this great football tradition in Acton-Boxborough.
And Tim, there's a great football tradition at Woburn. Woburn last year lost to AB and then wound up going 5-5. They were Super Bowl champions just 6 years ago. And they've had a great tradition. Rocky Nelson, in his 26 years, won over 200 games. So they felt that they were on the rise this year. We'll see how they do with the rest of their season.
Time we kick it down, another squib up the middle, and handled, and tackled by number 23, Ray Yost.
Okay, good special teams tackle by Yost.
That Super Bowl team 6 years ago by Woburn, or actually the year before that, the year after that, when they had Mike McLaughlin.
Yeah, Mike McLaughlin, absolutely.
I just heard that Mike's playing in the NFL, special teams.
I didn't know that.
For Baltimore, I believe.
Well, that's great. Nothing doing. I think that's Cornelio.
boy, AB, it's just they're blitzing every single down. Somebody's coming. Two minutes and counting in the first half.
Yeah, McLaughlin played against AB during the streak years, and wound up playing in the Shriners game, and had a great career at Boston College. So we've got a couple of Boston College guys made. Mark Herzlich, a fantastic, credible story, coming back from cancer and making the New York Giants team.
I heard he was the 53rd kid to make, player to make the team.
Wouldn't surprise me. Oh, they convert! That was the harmonic convergence.
And it was, wow.
Brooks Poulin, Marcotte.
From behind, Sean Whittier.
Whittier, Poulin, and Marcotte, yep.
That's a bruising combination.
And once again, it's third and long for the Tanners. They seem to be in this position for the whole half, except for that first play where Ortiz broke it for about 60 yards. Nothing's been doing for these guys.
All right, third and 15. And Chucky Ortiz is in the slot, I formation.
There's a blitz. Oh, he's got him!
Wow!
And that is Peter
Trombley with a big time sack.
And timeout, good timeout. They're calling timeout, but the time is still going.
No, they should. Great play by Peter Trombley. Took a lot of speed to keep after.
Well, when you talk about linemen, it's not the 40-yard dash; it's the 10-yard dash. It took him about 5-6 seconds to call that timeout. For the refs to give him the timeout after he called it. Are they going to come in for the block here?
Billy Jackman back deep.
No, they're pulling back.
And it's a
that could go the other way. That could go the other way.
And it looks like we'll get the ball.
Okay,
there. The Woburn 48 with 41 and a half seconds to go.
I think the timekeeper here at Woburn is playing a little fast and loose with the clock, because we had about 4 seconds tick off after that was called. So let's see what happens here. Let's see if Ethan airs it out, yet to complete his first pass, and really hasn't needed to throw the ball.
Matt Marcotte at wingback. Give us the swing dog as he cuts up again. What a beautiful run for about 6 yards.
Where's the timeout? They're not calling timeout.
Behind the blocking of Matt Marcotte.
Well, the clock is running. I don't understand why they're not calling timeout.
Billy Jackman split out. There they go, 16, 15 seconds and counting, back to pass. Ethan Dukes under pressure here. He's gonna throw an interception to number 13, or number 12, I should say. Really didn't have his feet set.
Martin. No, not at all.
He
just threw it up for grabs. He didn't have a whole lot to lose with 6 seconds to go. But maybe they were out of timeouts, but I didn't understand why they did. No, they still have 3 timeouts left. So that was not great clock management here at the end of the first half. Well, do you give it to Chucky and see what he can do, or you just take a knee with 6 seconds to go here?
Oh, no, I think you give it to Chucky.
We've got our secondary back about 40 yards.
No, Chucky's in the slot.
Ultimate prevent defense here.
Back to pass, looking for Chucky. And that, there's Evan Longer.
And that's it.
Flank there, and that's gonna be the first half. See if they call it, yep. So, Acton, Boxborough, 19 and the Tanners, nothing, I'll tell you. This 2011 edition of the Colonials looks mighty good there, Mark.
They do. They look great. That's one of the best halves of football I've seen in a few years, frankly. We'll be back for the second half.
All right. Second half, 19-0 at the box roll, and it's off in the air, and it's a squibbler onside kick. And Jake Plecky's on top of that ball. And let's see. Looks like we've recovered it.
Yeah, really heady play by Jake. That ball was squibbing all over the place.
It really was a tricky...
Good hands.
All right. So great field position for the Colonials. Looks like maybe a flag on the play.
It could be offside against Woburn on the onside kick. Let's see. No. All right, we get the ball on the 45.
Wow, great field position here.
Okay, do you go for a quick strike here? Gear it out?
Absolutely. I think we got to start testing stuff.
We got to test this secondary. Great play action play. Oh, we got some fireworks in the background. Let's see if we can get some fireworks of our own here.
I draw the defense offsides. Here we go, a little fullback.
That's a little late action there. A little late action.
A little cross pop. And Woburn had that covered.
That's really the first time Sweeney has really been stopped. All right, let's see if Jake can get his hands on the ball. Let's see if we go to the air here.
Swing dog in a Delaware. Yep, it's a perfect call against that, Mark. They had the middle covered. You run a Delaware sweep, and bingo, 9 yards.
And that is just at the first down marker. Oh, bad spot. Bad spot.
Really.
Third and two.
Two down territory right there.
Absolutely.
Bring in Brooks Poulin. They'll probably run flex here. See if we do. And we do. We run flex. Swing dog cuts through for plenty of yards there as he gets about six.
And I think the whole Tanner defense, when they saw Poulin come in at fullback, thought it was going to be Poulin up the middle. Great play call by AB. And they moved the chains with 9:32 to go.
Ball on the 32-yard line of the Tanners. First and 10. Flex again. Flex to the weak side. There it is. Matt Marcotte pounding at the middle. And that kid, you watch this kid run. He's got great vision.
First down. They're moving the chains again. Well, now it's a game of pick your poison, Tim. Whether it's going to be Sweeney or Marcotte, Jackman.
That kid's got great vision, really good balance, and I tell you, he's a great back. He's going to get plenty of yards this year if he stays healthy. All right, flex right. Again, Marcotte on the outside and pushes his way all the way to the 9-yard line. He's a tough kid to bring down.
I'll tell you, the whole left side of the O-line just absolutely flattened the defensive line of the Tanners there, allowing Marcotte to get that yardage. Marcotte got a couple yards on his own there at the end.
First and goal on the 9.
Very impressive short drive. You got James Sumner in here. And they're keeping their players fresh, Tim. Got a lot of depth.
They really do. They rotate a lot of kids. Okay, James Sumner now, the tailback on the flex. Play action. And the pass is.
Oh!
Looks, I couldn't it see. Was, it was
it, yeah, no, it was completed. I thought it
on
was.
On the 1, okay.
Yeah, I thought it was intended.
It was
Mike Murphy that caught the pass. But I thought that pass was intended for Sweeney. and was overthrown, but Mike Murphy was right there on the 1 yard line.
The ref could help me with the call here and just make the call that it was caught. All right, second and goal on the one. Flex again.
That's it, he's in, he's in.
Marcotte. Up and over for touchdown. I think the coaches are just making sure we don't show chums for too much this game here. So
I think they're really playing it tight to the vest, and they don't have to do anything other than that. They haven't really unleashed any exotic plays here. It's been very basic AB football.
Probably have only run six different plays the entire game so far.
So that means that the first play against Chelmsford is going to be like an alley-oop, Hail Mary, hook and ladder play.
Whoa, ball was skipped.
Oh, nice. Nice recovery.
Wow.
Jackman and Perry made a nice recovery on that.
That ball was a grounder that wound up in a perfect hole. So with that, 7:33 to go in the third quarter, it's the Colonials 26 and the Tanners nothing.
Well, now that it's 26 to nothing, I want to talk a little bit about how everybody is viewing Acton-Boxborough. And right now, they have conquered as the top team in the DCL over everybody else. And I think that has a lot to do with that great run of George Cran. But AB is preseason number 34 or number 36 in the various polls. So I think this is a very important game into getting back into the conversation, climbing back into the top 20, making a name for yourself. And that's what we're used to at Acton-Boxborough. And this has been a really successful program, and looks like they started off pretty well this year.
I absolutely agree. And where is Woburn in the rankings?
Woburn was lower, but they did pick Woburn. Three sports groups picked Woburn to win this game.
All right, here we go. Another bloop kick.
Oh.
Oh, man, he just ducked away from getting demolished.
That looked like Jacoby Ellsbury coming in at center field and just sliding for the catch.
First and 10, Tanners on their own 39-yard line.
Boy, those kicks are all adventures, aren't they?
That ball was hung up in there. That's a tough. You need a lot of guts to catch that ball.
All right, we'll see if the Tanners can get anything going here.
First team D is still on the field. Give us to Chucky Ortiz. Wow, does he show great speed.
Oh, Billy Jackman once again makes a touchdown saving tackle as Ortiz cut and Jackman just got a hold of him.
He gets out to the flat area so fast.
Yeah, and he cuts so well and so quickly.
Right, little slant play for two or three.
I think Mike Duggan might be in on that play. As you say, Sean Whittier's been doing a great job. He's been in quite a bit and doing a really good job.
Kid is a huge competitor, just a huge heart. You do one-on-one drills with this kid.
Well, he's like we had before many players that. Low to the ground, kind of wrestler mentality.
You put him head up when he's, just a little kid against somebody like Poulin, where you really try to ration against the kids because you can hurt people, and Whittier would just stand right up to kids like that, no problem. Just a really great kid.
Pete Trombley on the stop, nice tackle by Pete. Puts Tanners in a third and five. Well, we really haven't called anybody's name in the secondary. We've got four players here in the secondary. We've hardly called their names here.
Peter Cannell, Akil Willis is playing corner there. Playing nice tight coverage. Screen play, Trombley. Nice. Whoa.
Oh, a little bit extracurricular.
Wow. Against his own player, Chucky Ortiz took number 73 here. And just gave him a, he just punched him in the head.
Yeah, I think he took exception to
where he was
on the field, I think.
Yeah, but man, he just didn't hit him in the pads. He just clocked him.
If I were Chucky Ortiz, I wouldn't do that more than once.
Yeah, the next time he goes out in that flat looking for a block isn't going to be there.
Fourth down, they're going for it.
Oh, great. All right, now we're going to call Akil Willis.
Akil Willis, absolutely.
All right. Well, you just mentioned his name. You must have whatever, you know. That.
Akil also is you'll see him as running back, and he's another great runner.
Well, I remember as a sophomore, he was a kick returner and made some nice kick returns.
All right, first and 10 Colonials.
Jake, let's check Jake Pilecki. He looks a little banged up in the huddle here. Let's see how he does here.
All right. And it's Brogy off on a little slant counter for a couple yards, 3-4 yards. Matt Brogy.
Well, they're staying with the conservative play calls. They don't have to do anything different. Fast moving quarter, 5 minutes to go.
Sween Dog out in the flats on the Delaware again as he cuts up for another about 4 or 5 yard run.
I love the way he runs. It's so fast. It's just like he's got one speed, everybody else has another speed.
As soon as you have a beat on him, he's gonna cut.
All right, let's see if Ethan takes it himself for a first down here. It's third and one. See if they work on their quarterback sneak play. Nope.
Little
all right.
Fullback dive, and it looks like Matt Brogy for the first down and more. Very good run, 5 yards.
You know, this game goes very quickly when you keep the ball on the ground. I mean, I may get home for the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. I'm not sure. I got to check the time, but it's a fast-moving game.
Sween Dog.
Oh, yeah.
It's caught in the backfield this time. Woburn snuffed out that Delaware.
Yeah, they blew that one up.
Coach Maber will come back with the fullback dive off of that formation in about 2 plays. You watch.
Okay, we've got Peter Cannell.
Wow, trips
slid right. Yeah, I got trips.
Brogy on the dive and taken down.
Well, the Tanner defense is stiffening here with 3:15 left to go in the third, and that's going to put us in a third and 15.
Our play calls are very conservative here, Mark, as you said. So. All right, slot left.
Very tight formation. Very tight.
Fumble snap.
Woburn recovers, looks like. At least they think they have the ball. Yep, Woburn ball. Okay, Tim, that's the first miscue for Acton Boxborough. Woburn takes over on the 49-yard line.
Coach Maber definitely talked to the team and say, look, we can play conservative, but let's make sure we take care of the football and stay disciplined.
Well, you do wonder sometimes with a big lead, sometimes you can get a little bit too conservative.
All out blitz by AB, and it could backfire. Oh, but no, a saving tackle. I think we blitzed all three linebackers.
Now this kid Ortiz was their leading rusher, their leading receiver, their leading return man last year. He rushed for over 1,000 yards, and I think he's gonna have a big season against the Middlesex League.
Whoa, big time run up the middle. Again, very aggressive blitz.
Yeah, he's a load when he gets going. Okay, so they've softened up the defense on the last two plays.
Bring up first and 10 for the Tanners on the AB 26-yard line, and Coach Maber calls a timeout.
Yeah, I get a sense that there's a sort of a loss of energy here.
Yeah.
You know, when you get a big lead, I think it's human nature just to relax a little bit, and I think that's exactly what's happening here. And I think Coach Maver is going to try to remind them that they're still in a football game. You know, this year, Tim, you know, we've always talked about back in the glory years with the winning streak, and where Everett was always a top team in Massachusetts and Acton-Boxborough was right there. We always talked about, will Acton-Boxborough ever play Everett? Well, this year they moved Everett down inexplicably. They moved the whole Greater Boston League down from Division I to Division 1A. And the way the playoff format is set up this year, if Acton-Boxborough wins out, they wind up playing Everett in Gillette Stadium. Wouldn't you love to be in Gillette against Everett in December?
That sounds like an incredible destination.
There's a blitz by
Chucky Ortiz in the flat, and Matt Marcotte stays with them in the flat and takes them down for a 5-yard loss.
And Akil Willis was right there. He was coming in on a corner blitz, and if Marcotte didn't get him, Akil Willis was right there to do it. Okay, they got their mojo back. They got a little talking to,
yeah.
And they're back playing football now.
You can see the energy.
Oh yeah,
a little offside.
Oh, that. Now that should be a personal foul on Ortiz. I mean, It's one thing to beat up on your own guy, but it's another thing to go after Akil Willis. That's a personal foul.
Ooh.
I'm sorry.
It's against Woburn anyhow.
Oh, okay.
Illegal procedure.
Well, yeah, but they should have called a personal foul also, because that was absolutely no excuse for that hit on Akil Willis. Well, clearly Ortiz is frustrated. You can tell. This is not how they expected to open their season.
But Ortiz is a captain. He's got to play like one, and he's really been a little out of his element here, I think.
Yep.
He's a heck of a player.
Second and long, second around 20.
Whoa! Ortiz explodes off tackle.
Well, that's what you're going to do. If you're going to answer, you answer on the field. You don't hit somebody in the head.
I think, Mark, again, you know, AB's defensive call, very aggressive. And we're just blitzing a lot, and you know, we're going to have to figure out how to play ball with those blitzes to make sure we operate the right contain strategy, etc. It's going to be a little tricky to learn it.
Yeah, it really is. It really is a high-risk defense. It's really high-risk, high-reward. When it works great. When it doesn't, you are vulnerable in the secondary. And against a runner like Ortiz, that's what happened.
They're going for two. And Ortiz is in easy. Coach Mayer does not look happy with the defense in that drive, as you said. You know, it's just quarter left of football. I think really what you wanted to see from your defense was leadership to take, you know, get the second and third team in for some more time, keep this game in control, and now first team's going to be in for a while.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. You're not going to be putting second and third teamers in with over a quarter to go. Woburn now has some hope. You know, it's still a three-score game for them, no matter what they do. But there's over a quarter of football to play, and anything can happen. So they've got the AB has got to get its focus back, and just a nice long drive, eat up the clock, nice and methodical. Once again, you have to watch for the onside kick. They tried it last time. They've got nothing to lose. Got a lot of points to make up.
That was a great kick.
You're going to have an onside or probably a squib kick.
Well, that shows
you how much I know.
Jackman touches the ball for the first time today, I think, as he cuts out to the outside, cuts back and inside, and up to the 30-yard line.
Oh, did you see that block by Kyle Sweeney?
That was a beautiful
block. I mean, he is not afraid to get in there and mix it up. And he really nailed the Woburn defender. So how many years did you coach Kyle?
Four, I think. Four, wow. 5 years, yeah. Wing right. Give us up the middle. And a great run. Wow, that's the way to respond. Pounding hit at the end there. Who was that? Was that Matt Marcotte?
I thought it was Sweeney, but maybe I was wrong. That's the end of the third quarter.
And there it is.
26-8.
Still can't tell who that passed. Maybe it was Brogy. I don't think Pullen was in. It'll be interesting to see how we respond here. This is good. You need a little bit of drop, you know, challenge in this first game to test, because you're going to run into chunks for next week, assuming we stay in control of this game.
Well, you know, next week you're playing a much more formidable opponent. And as you say, they really haven't opened up the playbook here, and I think you're right. I think it's for a particular purpose. The Chelmsford scouts are here. You don't want to show them everything you have if you don't have to. If you need the play, you run the play. If you don't need the play, then why show it?
Speaking of football in another land, so to speak, did you see the University of Maryland's opening game in those ugly uniforms?
No, I didn't. Tell me about those ugly uniforms. How ugly were they?
I guess the uniform was in the shape of the coat of arms, if you will, and it literally had two halves to it. It was like a character in a Batman movie or something. It was two different colors. It was voted the ugliest football uniform ever by all sorts of people on the web and so on.
Really? No
kidding. You have to go on YouTube and check
them out. I'm going to do that. Are they going to keep the uniforms, or are they going to change them?
Plenty of press on.
Wow.
So anyhow, wing right, second and a yard for Colonials. Play action pass, Ethan Dukes.
Oh, overthrown, and that's, you know what, there's a lot of chippiness there.
Yeah.
That was an unnecessary hit.
Wow.
And Matt Murphy is limping right now. Woburn's getting away with some personal fouls here. That's at least two.
All right, third and one. We got to take it to him here.
Oh, Not a problem. Look at that hole.
Matt Brogy with a great run up the middle. Solid run.
But it was at the offensive line. Trombley, McGavick. Unbelievable. Matt Duggan playing both ways. Sides, excellent, excellent blocking.
All right, first down Colonials as they get all the way out to the 47-yard line. Sween Dog and Brogy. Sween Dog cut up on a Delaware as he cuts back over for another 9-yard run.
That's a great run. I want to tell you, Barry Wolfson, he pulled on that play, and he looked as fast as Sweeney, and he got a great block to allow Sweeney that 8-yard gain. Number 51, Barry Wolfson. He really got off the blocks in a hurry on that, and you have to make that play successful. You've got to have a lot of speed.
Mishandled snap.
Okay, he made something out of that.
We've had two or three today, so we got to fix that as well. Second and about first down. Everything's going well tonight.
Ethan is on the ground right now, and Mr. C is coming out, and this is not good. Looks like he's looking at his ankle here.
Yeah.
Hopefully it might just be a cramp. It looks like he's working it like it's a cramp. Let's hope for that. Well, that would be a huge loss.
Ethan really got a lot of experience last year. As you know, unfortunately, Mikey Morris injured early in the season, and Ethan really stepped up admirably and guided the Colonials to a very successful season.
Yeah, he was just thrown into it, and he performed very well. But he didn't get a chance to play much defense last year, and he loves to play defense. He just loves that linebacker position. It looks like a cramp.
Taking a drink.
I think it's just a cramp. I'm certainly hoping it's nothing more than that. You know, Mr. C, he's like a medicine man. He's like an old time medicine man. He's got stuff that, you know, just from plants and trees and bark and everything.
That's how powerful Mr. C is.
When you think of how many teams we have and how he gets around, he is the busiest man in town.
He really is. It's just amazing. You know, you look at the schedule and, you know, he's at the volleyball game, then he's at the, you know, the football game.
He's really a great guy.
He's always there.
Exactly. And there are so many parents. I mean, I'm very thankful to Mr. C for a couple of situations with our son, and there are so many parents who feel the same way and had great experiences with Mr. C.
Well, that's a good sign. Ethan's walking out the field.
Looks like a cramp. Looks like it was a cramp. We'll see probably Peter Cannell come in at quarterback to spell Ethan for a while. Well, our game situation is first and 10 from the 43-yard line for AB. 9:42 left in the fourth quarter. AB with a 26-8 lead.
So I meant to tell you earlier that I have a feeling as to, you know, why Woburn really puts out a big team every year. I think, you know, we're only like 2.5 miles from Polkari's.
Aha!
I think that's the answer.
Peter Cannell.
Yeah.
Taking his first snap.
They give us to Matt Brogy. He cuts out on the outside and runs tough for a big time 6-7 yard run.
He was fighting off two or three defenders, and I mean really fighting them off to get that extra couple of yards. A good run by Brogy. Peter Cannell getting some very valuable experience here.
Peter Cannell played some quarterback for me as well. He's a very competent kid. He knows how to run the offense. And another Delaware, this time Woburn. Stops Sween Dog for about a 3 or 4 yard gain.
I think he's got a first down. Let's see what it looks like. Very close. No? But third and one, I would say.
You know you're having a great night when a 3 yard run looks like you know.
Yeah, exactly.
A failure.
Okay, third and short.
I don't think we have our flex formation out there. We'll see.
Well, certainly four down territory here with third and one. Just kill some clock here. Keep the chains moving.
James Sumner at wing. And a big time dive up the middle. Who was that?
That was Brogy, and Brogy is taking on 4 and 5 defenders and moving that pile. I mean, he is another strong.
Look at him
kid.
Get up too. It's great. This kid is. He's having a good night. He really is.
Brogy carried 4 defenders on that play.
He's taking care of the football. He's having a great night. 8:01 to go in the game.
Okay, we got James Sumner, Sweeney, Brogy.
It's Brogy again off tackle for about 3 yards. Four or five yards here. Great carry.
Yeah, Brogy's probably saying, I want a piece of those guys. You know, just let me at them. And Brogy gets a well-deserved rest. Nice running by Matt.
Poulin and Marcotte check in. I would guess we're going to run flex now. Imagine those two guys as a flex block back.
Oh, my God. I would not want to be on the other side of that line.
Get the heck out of the way. Look at that blocking tandem.
Oh, look at that hole. Look at that hole.
Cuts again. Spins around. Keeps going. Cuts again. Touchdown. Wow. Man. Now that is a ridiculous run.
There are bodies.
And there's Sweet Dog's mom right there.
There are bodies strewn all over this field, and they all have black uniforms on. That hole opened up, but you talk about Marcotte and Poulin just opening the way for Sweeney, and then Sweeney, once he got out there, did the rest of it on his own.
That was just, I think that run and the run where he cut laterally on the 30 on the other side of the field, two best runs of the night, even though there's some explosive touchdown runs, the first play of the game, but I still like those two runs.
Yeah, now that's offsides. Doesn't matter. Okay.
So with 7:03 to go, it's the Colonials 33 and the Tanners 8.
Well, I don't want to get ahead of myself here, but I think Acton Boxborough is starting a winning streak. This will be number one.
I have to say, I agree. It's really been an impressive night. Like I said, it's been a very conservative game on purpose. But, you know, certainly it's nice to see, first of all, a team with a strong, you know, that's strong at the line of scrimmage. Because from there, you build out. Any good football team has a strong line on both sides of the ball. And it's clearly that this team has that. You know, we stay healthy. This line can do a lot of things.
Absolutely.
And it may be one of the best lines that we've had in quite some time. And
I agree. From what I've seen, having watched AB football for many, many years, this looks like one of the best lines we've ever had.
And then, of course, you know, the depth at fullback with Poulin and Marcotte, that's about as tough as you're going to get as well. We've had some great fullbacks over the years, but they join those ranks certainly demonstrating that in their first game out here.
You know, you look like you have a couple of draft horses in the flex when they line up. You just don't want to be, you don't want to be on the other side of the field.
Looks like we were offside there, but we got away with it. And Woburn takes it up across the 30 to the 34-yard line, first and 10.
Okay, Nico Cornelio hasn't done much. All right, let's see if we've got some. We have William Tejeda, Max's younger brother, in the game. Talk about a couple of kids who look like they're out of the same gene pool. When you look at William, you see Max.
All right, AB on a blitz again.
Oh, and my goodness. Marcotte.
And Brandon Sides
and Marcotte. And of course, Matt Duggan came in late to take part of the glory. Mike Duggan, we got to talk to Mike about that.
He just wants to touch that football every play.
Just wants to be on camera, I think.
He's had so many tackles tonight on his own anyhow that, they, you know, I'm like, geez, there's a big enough computer to tabulate that.
There's no chance. It's almost like there's no O-line for Woburn. Sides again. Sean Whittier in on that one.
Pulling.
Everybody. It's like they have absolutely no defense for the strength of this defensive line. And when I spoke with Coach Glant, he said, just watch this line play. And they're everything that he described.
Oh boy, Chucky Ortiz on the flat. And
oh,
cuts
he alerted Mikey Duggan. That's the first time that Duggan has missed a tackle. But he didn't get too far. It's fourth down. They should be kicking at this point.
Absolutely kicking, for sure.
And now we may see some new uniforms come in. A tremendous effort on the part of the Colonials to start the season. A lot of question marks. Every season brings new questions, and they had so many starters graduate. You just wondered what kind of team this would be.
End over end kick, and Jackman fields it on his own 30. Has some room on the outside. Cuts back over the middle. It's still going across the midfield to the 47-yard line of the Tanners.
Good return by Jackman. Nice blocking by Brogy just to hold up a Woburn defender to give Jackman opportunity to make that return. Okay, Thomas Carter is in. 6 feet, 220-pound junior. We've got Max Edmond, 5'11", 175 sophomore. David Jamrog, who is expected to see some time. 6'2", 175, he's a senior.
Hunter Arnold at quarterback. Little off tackle run by number 35.
Yep.
Sapanero, Thomas Sapanero. About 2 or 3 yard gain.
Well, you know, as parents of a football player, it's so exciting as a sophomore to see your son play as a sophomore. Even in a mop up role, it's so exciting for these kids to see varsity playing time in their first game as a sophomore.
Delaware sweep with Sapanero again for maybe a yard or two. 3:37 to go in the game.
Okay, we've got Evan Callahan.
Dan Linker.
And Evan's a big kid. He's 6'3", 185. Like his brother, big kid.
Wow. Wow, Woburn all over that play.
Yeah, yes. Ray Yost on the run, and it's fourth down, and they're gonna punt. Just let the clock run, 2:55 and counting. Well, Coach Maver is going to tell these kids that they're not as good as this score. Their first scrimmage against Andover, they just got their lunches handed to them. And Coach Gallant said the reason why is that they felt that just because they were acting Boxborough and the Colonials, they could just walk out on the field and dominate. And Andover showed them that they had to really focus, work hard, and play every play. And then they turned it around with two really good scrimmages against Holy Name and Natick. And they're gonna play their best next week against Chelmsford.
Jack Perry punting. So Ethan Dukes is not out there. Gets a little good kick to the...
That's actually a great kick. That's a great kick. Oh, and a great... Oh, that's fantastic.
Slide to home plate there.
I think that's a Kasha, and he was safe at home.
Another great kid.
What nice play. And so Woburn's got 98 yards with 2 minutes and 16 seconds to go.
Nice to see that kind of aggressive focus at this point in the game with that score. That says a lot.
And it's also great for, great for him. I mean, it's you get into the game, you make a great play, and you just feel good about yourself.
Sure.
And that's just part of playing football. And you feel like you're helping the team. Okay, this is football version of garbage time here. Down to 2 minutes to go.
It's nice to have those 2 minutes though when your opponent is pinned down on their side of the field.
Okay, Thomas Carter on the stop. He's a big kid, junior.
Bring third down.
These kids should get more playing time as the season progresses.
1:21 to go.
New quarterback.
Back to pass.
Oh, okay.
That's a good completion there.
No, I'm sorry, that was still Romano in there.
But he really threw that up for grabs, so it just seemed like he didn't even square. He just chucked it out in the flat. Who caught that? I didn't see.
I don't think there have been more than three pass completions the whole game.
All right, 53 seconds and counting, winding down. Romano with the handoff to number five.
He looked like a lot like Chucky Ortiz on that
Jared
play.
Jared O'Brien. This should be the last play of the game.
40 seconds here. No timeouts. Gonna let the clock go. Great win for the Colonials tonight. They look good. Both sides of the ball.
That's a dive up the middle. And that should be it, Mark, as we wind down the clock with the Colonials taking the Tanners 33-8 tonight on this just a beautiful night and a great way to open up the season with these kids. I think they really showed us proud. They learned a couple of lessons along the way, the easy way with the score being so nice here. Maybe one more play to go. They do get it off. They run a Delaware. And it's well covered
stop.
By the Colonials.
Good stop by Cotter. Cotter looks like a player.
So that's all she wrote. And we hope Ethan Dukes is okay as he was held out the second half. But give these kids a lot of credit. The defense looks good. The offense looks good. The team looks great.
I'm really
excited.
I'm very excited about next Friday night. We're going to be home. The Velvet Voice is going to be announcing up in the booth. And next week, it's the Chelmsford Lions.
And so many great games over the years with the Lions. So every time AB gets on the field with the Lions, you know you're going to get your money's worth. So that's terrific. So we'll see everybody next week. Take care, everybody.